Many people have a misconception and they think that jihad can only be done by a Muslim. There are many verses in the Quran which say that even non-Muslim did jihad. Quran says in Surah Luqman, chapter number 31, verse number 14, we have enjoined on the human beings to be kind to the parents. In travail upon travail, the mother bore you, and in pain did she give you birth. Immediately after praising the parents, especially the mother, the verse continues. Surah Luqman, chapter 31, verse number 15 says that, but if your parents do jihad, strive and struggle to make you worship somebody else besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, besides Almighty God, of whom you have no knowledge, then don't obey them. But yet, live with them with love and companionship. Here the Quran is talking about non-Muslim parents doing jihad, striving and struggling to make their children do shirk, worship somebody else besides Allah. A similar message is given in Surah An-Kabut, chapter number 29, verse number 8, that we have enjoined on the human beings to be kind to the parents. But if their parents do jihad, they strive and struggle to make you worship somebody else besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, besides Almighty God, then don't obey them. So here the Quran is talking about non-Muslim parents doing jihad. And there are various such examples of Quran mentioning non-Muslims doing jihad. Now this type of jihad, in Arabic, we say jihad fi sabil shaitan. Jihad in the way of the Satan. What we Muslims should do is jihad fi sabilillah, jihad in the way of Allah. And whenever the word is mentioned individually about jihad, in the Islamic context, it is understood it is jihad fi sabilillah. Many people have a misconception and they think that jihad can only be done by a Muslim. There are many verses in the Quran which say that even non-Muslim did jihad. Quran says in Surah Luqman, chapter number 31, verse number 14, we have enjoined on the human beings to be kind to the parents. In travail upon travail, the mother bore you, and in pain did she give you birth. Immediately after praising the parents, especially the mother, the verse continues. Surah Luqman, chapter 31, verse number 15 says that, but if your parents do jihad, strive and struggle to make you worship somebody else besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, besides Almighty God, of whom you have no knowledge, then don't obey them. But yet, live with them with love and companionship. Here the Quran is talking about non-Muslim parents doing jihad, striving and struggling to make their children do shirk, worship somebody else besides Allah. A similar message is given in Surah An-Kabut, chapter number 29, verse number 8, that we have enjoined on the human beings to be kind to the parents. But if their parents do jihad, they strive and struggle to make you worship somebody else besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, besides Almighty God, then don't obey them. So here the Quran is talking about non-Muslim parents doing jihad. And there are various such examples of Quran mentioning non-Muslims doing jihad. Now this type of jihad, in Arabic, we say jihad fi sabil shaitan, jihad in the way of the Satan. What we Muslims should do is jihad fi sabilillah, jihad in the way of Allah. And whenever the word is mentioned individually about jihad, in the Islamic context, it is understood it is jihad fi sabilillah.